This tutorial will show how to create a student contact group using Google Forms to collect the data. A contact group is handy if you easily want to set up sharing permissions between yourself and a large group of people, in this case, the students in a particular class, block, etc. To do that, you would use the navigation grid in Google Apps to go to Contacts. Once in Contacts, you would use the New Group option on the left-hand side to create a group. For example, Blue Block Students. Once you're in the group, you would then click the Add button and start adding in the members of the group, students for example, by typing in either their names or their email addresses. This can be a lot of typing. And you got to make sure you're typing in things correctly with respect to spelling. There's an easier way to do this. You can do this using a Google Form. So here I am using a Google Form. If you need help on how to create a Google Form, please refer to the Google Form section of our GAF support site. The key when you're going to create a Google Form is these two options at the top of the form. Making sure the box checked off for require York School Department login to view the form, so that only people within our organization can access this form, and to automatically collect the respondent's York School Department username, because that's really all the information you need. You don't really need any of this information that I've entered below. However, a Google Form needs at least one field in order to be a true form, so I simply put in first name, last name, and I also add a section for the students to put in what block or section they're in, just in case I might need this data later. But again, the key are these two checkboxes at the top. Once complete, this is what your form will look like to the student. They'll need to be signed in to fill out the form. They'll put in this information and hit submit. When complete, you go and look at the spreadsheet that's collecting the data, which will look something like this. The only information you really need are the username column. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight the usernames and I'm going to copy them. I'm going to use Command C. And now I'm going to go back to Google Contacts. I'm going to click the Add to Blue Block Students group. And I'm going to now use the paste command, or Command V, to add those email addresses or usernames from my students into this list. I'm going to click Add, and it will add their names to the list. These are, of course, our fake usernames. If they were real students, you would see their names listed in this column right here, letting you know that Google Contacts has successfully synced the email addresses or usernames with the actual students, so that your contact group looks something like this. Email addresses here, full first and last names listed here. So, to review, an easy way to make a quick contact group in Google is to use a Google Form to collect that data from students, say at the beginning of the year. The questions on the form aren't as important as making sure these two checkboxes at the top are active. Sharing the form so that students can access it, having them fill out the form, and then from the spreadsheet that's collecting the data, highlight just the data that's in the username column, and then paste that information into your Google Contact group. This concludes this tutorial.